There are a few elements that are key to reporting the WWC's findings from study reviews. The WWC calculates each of these elements for findings that meet WWC group design standards with or without reservations. Let's examine each reporting element in detail. The WWC measures the magnitude of findings, that is, the size of the difference in outcomes between the intervention and comparison groups, in three ways: as a mean difference, as an effect size, and as an improvement index. First, the mean difference measures the magnitude of the effect of the intervention using the units of the outcome measure. This is calculated as the difference between the average outcome for intervention group members and the average outcome for comparison group members. The mean difference may be adjusted for baseline differences, either by the WWC or by the study authors. We will discuss these adjustments later in this module. Mean differences can be translated into the second measure of magnitude of findings, effect sizes. The effect size represents the impact of the intervention in standard deviation units. Because the effect size provides a common scale for measuring impacts, it can be used to compare findings across different outcome measures. For the same reason, the effect size allows the WWC to aggregate impacts across outcomes and studies to summarize evidence. During the course of a study review, the WWC may calculate an effect size at two different points. First, when assessing the magnitude of differences between the intervention and comparison groups at baseline. We discuss this process in Module 3, Baseline Equivalence. Second, when calculating and reporting the effects of the intervention, which is the focus of this module. As discussed in Module 3, Baseline Equivalence, the WWC reports two types of effect sizes. For continuous measures, the WWC uses Hedges G. This is the mean difference divided by the pooled standard deviation of the outcomes. The pooled standard deviation is the weighted average of each group's standard deviation. For dichotomous measures, which are those with only two possible categories, the WWC calculates and reports the Cox index, which yields an effect size measure that is comparable to Hedges G. The formulas for these effect size measures are in the WWC Procedures Handbook and were introduced in Module 3, Baseline Equivalence. The WWC uses the same formulas for outcome measures that it does for baseline measures. The formulas require the mean and standard deviation of the outcome measure along with sample sizes separately for the intervention and comparison groups. As a reminder, the WWC's Study Review Guide has tools to assist with these calculations and all calculations described in this module. The Study Review Guide is discussed in detail in Module 9. Many study authors do not report the unadjusted means and standard deviations for each outcome measure in their study. There are a variety of statistics they may report instead. Often, these statistics are based on analyses that adjust for one or more baseline measures. Because these approaches account for the possibility that there may be some differences between the intervention and comparison groups at baseline, the WWC prefers adjusted impacts to unadjusted impacts. The WWC Procedures Handbook includes a set of formulas to calculate the effect size from statistics that result from a number of common analyses, including ordinary least squares, hierarchical linear models, analyses of variance, analyses of covariance, and tests of differences in group means. The WWC's Study Review Guide supports each of these calculations. The WWC will report the effect size as reported in a study, if it is comparable to Hedges G. The WWC also reports a third measure of the magnitude of an impact called the improvement index. Some WWC products report the improvement index in addition to an effect size. For example, the improvement index is reported in intervention reports, but not practice guides. What does the improvement index mean? It is a transformation of the effect size that represents the expected change in percentile rank for an average comparison group student if the student had received the intervention. Put another way, it measures the effect of the intervention in percentile points if the comparison group's average performance was at the 50th percentile. For example, if the average impact of an intervention is 0.4 standard deviations, it can be shown that the average comparison group student, a student at the 50th percentile, would be expected to score at the 66th percentile if he or she had received the intervention. The difference between 66 and 50 of 16 percentile points gives the improvement index. The WWC Study Review Guide calculates the improvement index for reviewers, and the WWC Procedures Handbook includes more information. In addition to the three measures of the magnitude of findings, the WWC also reports the statistical significance of the findings. An effect is described as statistically significant when the measured difference in outcomes is unlikely to have been observed under the assumption that the intervention had no impact. The WWC follows a standard convention that labels a finding statistically significant if the probability of observing an effect that is at least as large as the measured effect under the assumption that the intervention had no impact is less than 1 in 20, or 5%. The WWC generally accepts study authors' calculations of statistical significance, with some important exceptions explained later in this module. When an acceptable calculation from the study is not available, the WWC applies an adjustment or performs its own calculation using a formula in the WWC Procedures Handbook. We can see how the WWC reports the magnitude and statistical significance of findings by looking at an example from a WWC intervention report. The Reading Recovery Intervention Report included findings from multiple studies in multiple outcome domains, including these findings in the alphabetics domain for a sample of grade 1 students from the Schwartz 2005 study. The table reports the intervention and comparison group means and standard deviations, the three measures of magnitude, and the p-value, which indicates whether a finding was reported as statistically significant or not. The WWC website also has a study page for Schwartz 2005, which includes some of the same information for these findings. The website reports the improvement index, but not the effect size. Also, the website reports whether the WWC determined the findings were statistically significant, but not the underlying p-values.